Nation song literalizes the whole idea of angels and demons talking on a person's shoulder, like in the old cartoons, and carries that to the most horrific effect that I could get hold of, or that I could produce. It's about a young schizophrenic and the chief voice that speaks into his ear and involves him in a fantasy world that becomes more and more real to him while taking him farther and farther away from his real life. I see it as a book principally about frailty and about illness. It's about the gap between the language of someone who's sick and someone who's healthy, and how over time that estranges those two groups from one another. I find particularly that in treatments of illness in fiction, illness and most particularly mental illness tend to be a background element. They're like the rain that's falling on the main character. They're like a soundtrack that's playing in the background. We see them across what's happening at the front of the scene. We catch glimpses of them instead of having to really occupy what is attacking the character. So for this project, I wanted to be that rain falling on the character, that soundtrack that's playing in the background, the better to show and to measure what weighs upon someone who's sick in the way that he is sick. Reversals were very important to the project. There's definitely a pattern in the book where his initiation into evil comes through attacking things that are dear to him. The book's always moving farther inside him towards what's valuable to him, towards what can save him. It's those specific things that the demon is working to pull apart. One of the reversals that I thought about in writing the book, there's a famous painting by Marcus Harvey. It was during the Sensation exhibition that made Damien Hirst and Tracy Emin famous back in the 90s. It's called Myra. It's a huge photograph of the child killer Myra Hindley. And what the artist did was he built her portrait of little tiny children's handprints. People have varying reactions to it, but what you can't argue with is it's an extremely powerful object, full of a terrible and dynamic tension. What I wanted to do in this project, and this actually was an image I put in my own head sometimes when I was lost in the middle of writing, is I wanted to reverse that. I wanted the portrait I'm making to be of this effectively innocent, effectively childish person who's been reduced so much by his illness, but to build his portrait out of all these moments that were making his life most difficult, that were sickening him further, and that in the end would lead to his total perdition. Ones who were important specifically for this project tended to be ones who work with incredibly dark material, and yet somehow their work amounts to a gesture of tenderness. Hubert Selby Jr. is a great example of how he delves into things that are extremely, extremely difficult, but they're all things, they're all important. His characters deserve and need to be seen in those kind of conditions in order to be loved in those kind of conditions. Sarah Kane is another hugely important writer for me, and she was twice as important for this project. The likes of Saad, for this particular project, his technique is very masterful and helpful, but I don't think I could produce an extended work of that kind without some kind of impulse towards. I guess I'm aspiring to the same kind of dynamic that I would point out in Selby. I think that literature can work harder at seeing people at their very lowest, because this is a stage that we're all going to cross at some point, unless we die peacefully in our sleep. We will all sicken. We will take care of people who sicken. And unless we develop some kind of expertise at it, we're going to do it poorly. So I couldn't delve into this kind of material without that sense of urgency, that sense of mission. So that's what saved me in writing it.